அம்புமிக்க சகோதரா சகோதரிகளே வணக்கம். தமிழ் மாநிலக்கம் மோஜிக்கம் பாரம்பரியத்திற்கும் உங்களுக்கும் நான் தலை வணங்குகிறேன். ஏற்றமாரி விலின் ஆனுக்கோ இன்கே பேன் இல்லே பிள்ளை கந்தைத்து கும்மிதியானி எட்ரசோன் மகாகவி சுப்பிரமணிய பாரதியின் மண்ணிலே நிற்பதர பெருமை பட்கிறேன். பின்னே நீ மக்தானவள் ஸ்ரீ பன்வாரிலால் புரோஹித் ஜி, ஸ்ரீ ஏ கே பழனிசாமி, ஸ்ரீ எம் தம்பி துராய், ஸ்ரீ பொன் ராதாகிருஷ்ணன், ஸ்ரீ ஓ பன்னீர்செல்வம் ஸ்பீக்கர், ஸ்ரீ பி தன்பால் மினிஸ்டர், ஸ்ரீ டிண்டிகல் ஸ்ரீ ஸ்ரீனிவாசன், ஸ்ரீ எஸ்பி வேலுமணி, லேடிஸ் அண்ட் ஜென்டில்மேன், ஆன் த ஒகேஜன் ஆஃப் த பர்த் ஆனிவர்சரி ஆஃப் செல்வி ஜெயலலிதாஜி, ஐ பே மை ட்ரிபியூட் டு ஹர் அண்ட் எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் மை கிரீட்டிங்ஸ் அண்ட் பெஸ்ட் விஷஸ் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ வேர் எவர் சி ஈச். I am sure she would be very happy to see the happiness on your faces. I am glad today to be able to launch one of her dream projects, the Amma two-wheeler scheme. I am told that on Amma's 70th birth anniversary, 70 lakhs plant will be planted across Tamil Nadu. Congratulations to everybody. These two initiatives will go a long way in the empowerment of women and the protection of nature. Friends, when we empower the women in family, we empower the entire household. When we help with the women's education, we ensure that the entire family is educated. When we facilitate her good health, we help keep the entire family healthy. When we secure her future, we secure the future of the entire home. And as a central government, we are working in this direction. Friends, the union government has focus on empowering ease of living for the common citizen. All our schemes and programs have been oriented towards this aim, be it financial inclusion, easy availability of credit for farmers and small businesses, healthcare or sanitation. This is the basic mantra with which the NDA government at the center is working. Over 11 crore loans have been sanctioned under the Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana. An amount of 4,60,000 crore rupees has been given to people without any bank guarantee. And most importantly, 70% of these beneficiaries are women. The success of this scheme, therefore, is proof that the women of India are now stepping out of the age-old shackles and seeking self-employment. We have taken a number of other steps, too, for women empowerment. In the recent Union Budget, we announced that the EPF contribution for new women employees will be reduced from 12% to 8% for 3 years. The employer contribution will remain 12%. Under the Stand Up India scheme, women entrepreneurs will be given loans worth 10 lakh rupees to 1 crore rupees. We have also made a change in the Factories Act and suggested the states that they allow women to work in the night shift as well. We have also extended maternity leave from 12 weeks to 26 weeks. Under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, the registry of the house is done in the name of the women. The Jandhan Yojana has also benefited women in big way. Out of 31 crore Jandhan bank accounts, 16 crore are of women. The percentage of total bank accounts held by women has gone up from 28% in 2014 to 40% today. The Swachh Bharat Mission has given women respect and dignity, which is their right. Rural sanitation coverage in the country has expanded from 43% to 78%. We work in a mission mode to provide toilets for girl children in all government schools. Friends, the schemes of the Union government are protecting nature even as they are empowering people. 29 crore LED bulbs have been distributed so far under the Ujala scheme. They have led to a saving of 15,000 crore rupees in electricity bills. They have reduced carbon dioxide emissions by a significant amount. The Union government has so far given over 3.5 crore free gas connections under the Ujwala Yojana. As women benefit from a smoke-free environment, the reduction in kerosene usage is also helping the environment. 9.5 lakh women in Tamil Nadu have benefited so far for this Ujwala scheme. Keeping in mind the issues of gas supply and sanitation in rural areas, the Union government has come up with a Gobar Dhan scheme. The aim is to convert animal dung and agriculture waste into compost, biogas and bio-CNG. This will raise incomes and reduce expenditure on gas. Friends, more than 24,000 crore rupees worth of projects are currently being implemented by the center in Tamil Nadu. All these projects have begun after the NDA government assumed the office. They include solar power plants, crude oil pipelines, national highways, and port-related works. More than 3,700 crore rupees have been sanctioned for the Chennai Metro Rail. When there was a Congress-led government at the center, Tamil Nadu had received 81,000 crore rupees under the 13th Finance Commission. After the NDA came to power, Tamil Nadu received 1,80,000 crore rupees under the 14th Finance Commission. This is an increase of about 120%. The government is working to provide a home to every person by 2022. About 1 crore houses have been built in the last 3 years. Tamil Nadu has been given about 700 crore rupees in 2016-17 and about 200 crore rupees in 2017-18 for rural housing. For urban housing, the state has been given over 6,000 crore rupees. Friends, farmers in Tamil Nadu have also benefited from the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. I am told that the claim amounts worth over 2,600 crore rupees have been given to farmers in Tamil Nadu so far under this scheme. The Union Government is working towards modernization of fishing in Tamil Nadu. Under the Blue Revolution Scheme, we are providing financial assistance to fishermen for long liner trawlers. Last year, we gave the state government 100 crore rupees to convert over 750 boats to long liner trawlers. Besides making their lives easier, such trawlers will also help the fishermen earn more. India's vast ocean resources and long coastline offer immense possibilities. The Union Government is working on the Sagarmala program to overhaul our logistics sector. This will reduce the cost of both domestic and foreign trade. It will also benefit people living along India's coastline. We have announced the Ayushman Bharat scheme in Union Budget. Each poor family will be given the facility of free medical treatment up to a cost of 5 lakh rupees per year at identified hospitals. This will help 45 to 50 crore people across the country. The Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana and the Jeevan Jyoti Yojana have provided insurance cover to more than 18 crore people. We have also taken other steps such as providing medicines at economical rates through more than 800 Jan Aushadhi Kendras. We remain committed towards working hard in bringing a positive change in the lives of people. I once again pay my respect to Selvi Jayalalita ji. I wish you all the very best. Thank you. Thank you very much. Vanakkam.